friction, static friction, law of friction. It is this force which always acts in a direction opposite to that in which the motion is desired, and which is called the force of friction, or rather static friction. First, the frictional force is a self-adjusting force and increases with the applied force, so as to be equal and opposite to it, until motion is just about to ensure. This maximum frictional force is called the limiting friction, and its value is different for different pairs of surfaces. Definition of static friction, law of friction. It is this force which always acts in a direction opposite to that in which the motion is desired, and which is called the force of friction, and rather than static friction. Second, the limiting friction between the surfaces to two bodies is directly proportional to the normal reaction to the supporting surface. F is directly proportional to R, or F by R is equal to mu. Static coefficient of friction is equal to limiting friction divided by normal reaction. Sliding friction, when the friction is about to attain its limiting value, we apply a force in the form of a gentle push to the body resting over the other, such that it is maintained in uniform motion over the latter. Then this force misses what is called the sliding friction between their surfaces. Angle of friction, cone of friction. If we place a body on an inclined plane, it is clear that it is under the simultaneous action of three forces, viz. First, its weight, W, acting vertically downwards at its center of gravity, G. Second, the normal reaction, R, of the plane, acting perpendicularly of the plane. And third, the limiting friction, F, acting upwards along the plane. If the angle of inclination of the plane be so adjusted that the body is just on the point of sliding down, it is clear that the three forces are in equilibrium and therefore concurrent, so as to be represented by the three sides of a triangle taken in order. Shows the angle of friction, cone of friction. If we place a body on an inclined plane, it is clear that it is under the simultaneous action of three forces, viz. First, its weight, W, acting vertically downwards as its center of gravity. Second, the normal reaction, R, of the plane, acting perpendicularly to the plane. And third, the limiting friction, F, acting upwards along the plane. This angle of inclination of the plane, lambda, at which the body is just on the verge of sliding down, is called the angle of friction. Since the body is in equilibrium, F is equal to W sine lambda and R is equal to cos lambda. So that coefficient of friction, mu, is equal to F by R, is equal to W sine lambda divided by W cos lambda is equal to tan lambda is equal to angle of friction. Rolling friction. The frictional force between the two surfaces when one rolls over the other is called rolling friction, and is found to be much less than when sliding occurs between the same two surfaces. Definition of rolling friction. The frictional force between two surfaces when one rolls over the other is called rolling friction, and is found to be much less than when sliding occurs between the same two surfaces. First, an iron cylinder rolling over a plane rubber surfaces. Case of a body in equilibrium on a smooth inclined plane under the action of a force. Let P be a body of mass m on a smooth incline, such that a force F acting on it at an angle with the plane keeps it in, and thus to simplify our calculations, let us imagine a virtual displacement dr is zero. Shows a body in equilibrium on a smooth incline under the action of force. Let P be the body of mass m on a smooth incline of angle theta, such that a force F acting on it at an angle phi with the plane keeps it in equilibrium. The normal reaction R of the plane obviously acts perpendicularly to the plane.